we're not gonna like spend a lot of time on each page of this, but this is just a comparison between the IS 3000 series and the DT 8000 series, which are these two. This is a 3035, this is a DT 8050M. So we'll just kind of quickly go through these so you can get a better idea of all the features that they had. So four models, one design. They all have this little quick unlock thing on the bottom. So you turn it, it's locked, you turn it, it's unlocked, and then you're supposed to be able to push this with your finger and open it up. I can't do it. But they are supposed to be easier to open. So anything that has an A after it means it has the anti-masking feature. If it has the M after it, it has the mirror optics, but no anti-masking. So this is just kind of a specification comparison between the lenses on each of the detectors and the range that it has, and how much current it draws and so forth. So it's got wall and cover tampers. The IS 3035 and the DT 8035 both have PET immunity. One's 80 pounds, one's 100 pounds. The other two are more commercial. So the 3050 and the 8050 don't have any PET immunity. And you can see one's dual tech and one's not in each line. Let's see. So this is the 3035, which is the one we have here. 40 by 56 range, cover and wall tampers, PET immunity 80 pounds. The DT 8035 is the dual tech one. And it has 100-pound PET immunity, which is it's pretty cool. Normally, with microwave, you have difficulty doing PET immunity. This is the 35-foot detection pattern. Very similar, well, just pretty much exactly what I showed you a while ago. And then these are the 50-foot range. These are the more commercial ones. So no PET immunity on these. And there's your detection pattern on those. You can see that on this one it goes out to 53 feet. And then you got your 53 feet here. A couple of look downs. So again, you're never going to have look downs when you have PET immunity. So that's an indication that this one doesn't have it. So you can see the 3050A and the 8050A both have the anti-mask feature. There's another thing that we'll go over that has some like concerns to look out for when recommending motions. Installation. So, like I said, I just wanted you all to see the features on this. So this is that locking screw. So you got a little indicator here. If it's over here, it's locked. If it's over here, it's unlocked. When it's unlocked, you're supposed to be able to push on this and just easily open it up. I have difficulty doing that. It comes with the screws inside attached, so you can't mess them up. And it also has little screw anchors that hold your screws for you while you're getting ready to drill them in, which is kind of cool. See the little, there's the little screw holders right there.
Customers will call and say they don't know what the screws are. Probably should
be
without the screws.
Yeah. And then the little terminal strips come out fairly easily. And when they go in, they just make contact. So you can wire and then put everything together and it all fits together. I'm not gonna look at all this stuff. This one is the weird one because it's got a trouble circuit, a tamper circuit, and then the alarm circuit. And there's in the installation instructions for this, it tells you how to wire if you want to use just alarm and tamper, or alarm and tamper and trouble. And it also has a built-in resistor. So this one, by default, it's set for 2K. So you don't have to wire resistors in these. You can just put it in and it's got its own 2K resistor inside. You can choose 1K, 2K, 2.2K, and 5.6K for different panel types. This is your, on the IS 3035, where you can enable or disable the look down. Here it is. So it's either off or on. Of course, if you enable look down, you're not doing pet immunity. That's the potentiometer that lets you set the microwave adjustment for the dual tech. So that's the 8035. And again, default is look down, disable pet immunity, enabled. So the 35 foot ones are more residential. So they come with the residential features enabled by default. And this is the DT80, well, this is the 8035. So again, look down, disable pet immunity, enabled. And on this one, the pet immunity is enabled with a dip switch. And again, look down. And your pet immunity. So that's the look down on those 8050s. To me, it's counterintuitive. I think that if you push it in, it should be disabled. And if you pull it out, it should be enabled, but it's just the opposite. And that's because of the whole mirror thing. So this is the internal resistor I was talking about. It's automatically set for 2K, which is what Honeywell uses. You can set for 1K, 2K, 2.2, or 5.6. You can only have one of those up, and all the others have to be down. If you do two, you're going to jack it all up. There's your antenna. There's your lift down. Microwave range adjustment. So counterclockwise is minimum. Clockwise is maximum when you're adjusting the microwave. So turn it all the way down and then just up a little at a time. Sorry, there's a lot of, okay. We're gonna try to do the flashlight feature on this IS3035. So one other thing I wanted to go over with you guys real quick. I made this comparison. This is from the data sheet. It's just a comparison chart between all those motions and their various features.
Is that on website or?
Well,
is that on our Google Drive?
Probably not, but I can put it on there.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think
what all the different motions are.
I could sign.
Yeah.
You could have been faxed, so if we can get on the site somehow.
Yeah. So this, I cut this out of the data sheet. Well, there's a comparison sheet for this that has like 4 pages. So I just cut this page out because it's just a good kind of guide. So if you got somebody that, you know, is worried about an anti-mask or a masking situation, like a business or a jewelry store or something like that, you'd probably want to recommend one of the anti-mask capable motions.
Now, the 6 PIRs and the 5800 PIRs and the RES, all of those are anti-masking that have all these features in them?
I don't think so. No, and that's one of the reasons I chose these motions to go over, because they had so many features. So the 1500 PIR RES, I'm sure, doesn't have it. I'd have to look at the features, but usually there's an A in the part number if it has the anti-mask feature.
Those are pretty basic motions, then.
Yeah, the PIR by itself with no RES and the PIR COM are a little bit more, I guess, feature-rich. But I don't know that they have any of these. None of them are dual tech. I don't think any of them have the anti-mask feature. So I'd have to look at the feature set for those.
Basically, wired motions are better motions.
Well, yeah, and usually these kind of motions are going to be going in like a commercial place.
Yeah.
Where, you know, their budget is probably bigger and their concerns are bigger.
Throughout the day, yeah. There's
yeah.
People
so I wanted to look at this real quick.